Hello everyone, we are here to talk about sharing files and folders on a local network. What we have here is our Windows 10 desktop, and I'm going to head into my File Explorer, which I'll click on my taskbar. When I open my File Explorer, I'm going to head over to my disk drive, which is my C drive. And in my C drive, we have the directory of support tickets. In this folder, known as support tickets, I have multiple ticket files. And for this video, we want to walk through how we can share these ticket files with other users on our local area network. This is really important for business as well as for home use when you're talking about easily sharing files and folders with your coworkers or family members. Now to get started, what I want to do is go back to the main directory, which is my root directory, which is my C drive. I'm going to right click on the folder support tickets. And where we used to see the item share in our menu, we now see give access to inside of Windows 10. Now, first thing is we can remove any shared access by using remove access, stop sharing the folder with other users. Or we can share easily with our home group with a permission of read, which is the view ability. People can view the files, but they can't change them. Or we can do home group with view and edit. Allows other people to change our files and add and delete files in our directory. Now we want to be a little more, let's say specific. And that means we're going to click specific people. Here, we're not going to do a default share with a home group, but we can select specific user accounts or groups of accounts. So I'll select specific people. My new window opens up for network access, and here we can see it has the default user account being shared with, which is us. We own it. We are the student account on this machine. Now, if I wanted to share with another user account that exists on this machine or on another computer, I would type in the name of that user account. If I want to share with a group of user accounts, I would type in the name of that group. If I just want to share with everyone on my local network, regardless of what their user account is on their machine, that they can access these files in this folder, I would type in a share of everyone. When I go ahead and click add, we'll see that it has a default permission of read. If I click on that, we'll see the other option is read write. With the default permission of read, anyone on my local area network will be able to access this folder and view the files inside. They can open the files and read the files, but they cannot change any data in the file or add or delete files in our directory. We'll leave that default permission of read, and now we'll click share. And when I click share, I get a pop-up here. My computer's asking me, do you want to turn on file and folder sharing for public networks? My computer right now believes it's on a public network. If I click yes, that's scary. Instead, I'm going to click no. Make the network that I'm connected to private and turn on file and folder sharing on this private network, which I'll select that option. From there, it says my directory of support tickets is now shared on the local network. Other people on their machines will be able to access it. Now, this is just one method of being able to share files and folders, but if you want a little more control, what we can do is right-click on our support tickets folder, and instead of doing give access to, this time we're going to go to properties. Instead of properties for our folder properties of support tickets, we're going to click on the tab sharing. And in sharing, if we want to do custom control, we can click here on advanced sharing. I'll select advanced sharing, and here we can see it says share this folder. The name of my share is support tickets. And with the name of support tickets, that's what other users will see. Comments, I can give a description about what this share is being used for. So this is to access and view current support tickets. There we go. And now if I want to control the permissions of who can access this, whether it's again users or groups, that's going to be right here. Also, I can control how many common current sessions exist. This is how many users can access this folder and view the files at any given time. It's set to the maximum for our Windows clients, which is 20. Windows Server operating systems can do more than this. So I'm going to go ahead and click on permissions. And inside of permissions, what we'll see here is there is the user account of everyone where anyone can access regardless of their account. Down below, we have permissions that we can change. I only want them to be able to read. I don't want to give full control where they can set permissions themselves. I don't want to give change where they can delete or add files or change the data. I just want them to have the access to read. With that selected, I can go ahead and click apply and the changes would take in force. If I wanted to add more groups or user accounts up above, I can use the add button. Or of course I can remove them if I don't want them to have access anymore. So I've got what I like here. Everyone has access to read. the administrator or owner of the file that has read and change in full control. So I'll go ahead and click apply. Those permissions will take effect with the OK button. And again, apply and OK. And down below, we have one last thing to concern ourselves with. This folder says people must have a user account and password to access files on our computer. This means that the everyone permission right now is not taking force. If I go on another machine and try to access this directory, it's going to bounce because I don't have the correct permission. If I want to truly share this directory with everyone, I need to go into my network and sharing center and change my computer's password protection. Let me show you. We can go through this a couple different ways. We can go through our start and settings, or we can even right click on our network icon and go to network and internet settings. Either way that we get there, we're going to go to sharing options. Inside of sharing options, there's a couple items in here. We need to scroll down and look for this all networks. And in the all networks dropdown, I can select that. And if we scroll down, we'll see here what's called password protected sharing. Right now it is on. It's on by default. This means only users on other computers with the user account and password that exists on my computer can access this file. If I want to allow everyone on the local network to gain access to this directory with those everyone permissions, I have to turn off password protected sharing because everyone is not going to have a user account and password sitting on my computer that they can authenticate against. They're just everyone. So I'll go ahead and click Save Changes. And now another computer will be able to access the support tickets directory. Let me show you. So here we are in a Windows 7 client. And what I'll do is open up the File Explorer. And inside of here on the left side again, we've got our menus. And I can go ahead and click on Network. And this Windows 7 client is on the same network as that Windows 10 client. Here I will see the name of that Windows 10 computer. And I can double click on that. And when I double click on that name, it's going to connect across the network and see the shared directory on that computer. And there they are, support tickets. I can open that directory and see all those files on the other computer. And I can open up one of those files. And look at ticket information is here. Now, if I wanted to make a change, like I'm going to Control A and delete all this and say, ha 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 ha, because I'm a malicious person. And I'll save it. Watch what happens. It exists. Do you want to replace? Yes. Access is denied. It does not let me change the file and save the file. So it won't let me save it. The ticket one is still the same information it was before. And that's because we set the read permission versus providing more control. And that would have been change permission. Or in the other view, it would have been a read write. So practice and work with your own file and folder sharing. Get comfortable using these different options of share files. Whether you're talking about give access to, or you're going straight into the properties and then being able to use the share tab. Have fun.